One of the quirkiest shops in Athens, and one of the most worthwhile visiting, is currently owned and run by Pantelis Melissinos, known as the artist and poet Sandal Maker. This business has been in the Melissinos family for 90 years. Pantelis' grandfather, Yorgos, opened a shoe store in 1927 in Pandrosu Street, Monastiraiki. Back then, Monastiraiki was the shoe district of Athens, and it wasn't long before Yorgos Melissinos began selling handmade shoes to some very important clients. Their luxury line of shoes drew in members of the Greek royal family, who used to visit the shop to buy their climbing shoes.
And the original shop was in Monastiraiki. That was my
grandfather's original shop. We shared a wall with a mosque. My grandfather had, the royals were like his clients, his customers. Queen Frederica, King Constantine used to come for shoes and...
Did the king and queen wear sandals or were they shoes at that point?
They wear sandals. The Queen of Spain was here about 3 years ago to buy sandals for the prince, the crown prince.
In the 1950s, post-war Greece was in political and economic turmoil. And when Yorgos Melissinos passed away, his son Stavros inherited a business that was on the brink of bankruptcy. Pantelis told me a bit about how the family fortunes reversed again.
My father started making the Greek style sandals because of an English choreographer, a lady. We don't know her name. We don't know anything about her, but she's actually the one who started the whole madness of the sandal business, because she asked my father for 6 pairs because she was choreographing something with, that had an ancient Greek theme. My father made a few more and he sold them the same day to American tourists. And during that time there was lots of poverty in Greece, so what he made was like what he would make in a month. So he started making sandals and everybody was laughing at him, but then when they saw that the business was great and the famous people started coming in to buy the sandals, they copied his designs and everything and they started making sandals themselves. The Beatles, Jack Ionassis were some of the people who came, Sophia Loren. In recent years, Jeremy Irons, other famous American actors and actresses, Barbara Streisand, and they keep coming in.
And they have so many styles to choose from. There are around 30 different designs, some of which are named after the famous face that requested them, but you don't have to be a celebrity to place an order to get your own bespoke design. Pantelis studied painting and design at Parsons School of Design in New York, and much of his work is on display in the shop. He's a multi-talented artist. Here's his watermelon chair, a huge hit with visitors and a much requested item. So far, he's refused to part with it. And if all that wasn't enough, he's also a poet and a playwright.
You seem to be carrying on as well the family tradition of poetry.
Yeah. At Parsons, I used to write plays for my colleagues, and I always used rhyme. My plays rhymed because I also like the French playwright Molière, because he's very funny and he's using rhyme in his plays. And rhyme makes the play, I think, even funnier. It's more stylized and funny.
His musical comedy, Bacchus, played for 2 years running and has received rave reviews from Greek critics.
Before that, I used to translate my father's poems into English.
Fitting, then, that the poet Sandal Makers relocated to a street steeped in poetic tradition. It was here that Lord Byron stayed with the Macris family and fell in love with their beautiful young daughter, whom he immortalized later in his Maid of Athens poem. I'm not surprised so much has been published about this shop over the years. It really does have its own rhythm and vibe. I say, long may the Melissinos family continue their line of poet sandal makers.